Báilame como si fuera la última vez. Y enséñame ese pasito que no sé. Un besito bien suavecito, bebé. Taki, 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 rumba.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Sarah. So, I know I haven't made a video in a while, and I'm really sorry about that. It's just things have been crazy for me lately, and I don't know. I haven't been up to making videos and stuff. But I'm back, and I'm making one today. I'm going to actually do a quick book review on this, which is by Girl Define. And anyone who knows me knows that I love Girl Define. I love Bethany and Kristen. They have helped me a lot with their books and stuff, and have opened my eyes to new things and everything. So when they announced that they were going to release this book, I got very excited because I figured it could help me with some stuff that I'm struggling with in my own life, and it pretty much did. And I got this book because, if you didn't see my last video, really, I am part of their launch team, so I got this book for free, along with a bunch of other things. And I took some time reading it, and I think I read it in a week. And just alone, it helped me so much, and it kept opening my eyes to new things, especially things that I, like I said, I'm struggling with in my own life. There are four parts. It broke down into four parts, and there is, I think, 15 chapters? I'm not sure. Yeah, 15 chapters. And each chapter explains something different. Each part is something different. Part one is called Broken Sexuality. Part two is called God's Specific Design. Part three is What Every Girl Needs to Know. And the last part is She Is Made Whole. So yeah, each part has, I think, like four chapters in it or so. It should. I'm not quite sure. But yeah, each chapter touches on something that as girls struggle with and everything, and chapter two actually opens my chapter two is basically about lust and stuff, and that is not just a man's problem, but it is also us women's problems, and that's something I struggle with a lot, especially I think every girl struggles with it, but as us Christian women, we struggle with it a lot more, I feel, because we know that it's a sin, and we know that we shouldn't be lusting over other guys or guys in general, and we shouldn't have these feelings and stuff. And I underlined actually one thing in this chapter that spoke out to me a lot, and it says that if lust stays under the false banner of being a guy-only issue, women will continue to stay silent in their bondage. We as women will remain alone and isolated in the battle. And I feel like that's true. That when you hear the word lust, you mostly think it's a guy's problem, when it's really not. It's like an everybody problem. And us women, we feel like we are stayed silent under our bondage and stuff, and they pretty much touch on that a lot. They say that lust is a bondage to us women, which is true and stuff. And then they have, like, in their chapter, they have like different like little things like these, and then it starts on a new thing, and this one says it's not a guy's problem, it's a human problem. And it's true, like I said, it's an everyone problem and stuff. So I've underlined so much in this book, and I've never done that in a book in my life. And the reason I've done that is because this book spoke out so much to me. Like, it touched me in a way that I didn't think it would. I felt like this was God's way of getting my attention through my sin and stuff that I've been dealing with, and stuff that I've been dealing with since pretty much last year with some stuff that happened to me. This was God's way of showing me that is not just a problem, that I can come to him to it. And it's a really good book. Like, in all honesty, this book is really good, and I feel like women in marriage a relationship or liking a guy or something, they should read this book to help them figure their own things out. And especially, like I said, as Christian women, we struggle with so much and we get torn by the world more and more, like, oh, you're a Christian, you shouldn't be like thinking that way, you know that that's not right, and like all this stuff. And it's not true. It's not. And it gets me upset when people say this, especially when they come to me and they say this, because yes, I am a Christian and I proclaim that I'm a Christian to people, and I try my hardest to live my life the way that God wanted. But the world we live in has so much like baggage and whatever, like it blinds us with everything we do, with the music we listen to, with the TV shows we watch, with the movies we see, with the books we read. There's like so much. Like, they even say in this book, in one chapter, I'm not sure what chapter it is, but they say stuff like that, and they say that sex is just thrown around so much. And it's true, it is. And I think for like us single Christian women, that is the most struggling thing we can do, but we can also not look into that and stuff. In chapter 8, it's called Imperfect Purity, and that caught my attention when I read this. And this chapter is, they touch on what is the wrong way impurity, and what women who are pure and stuff think is wrong. Like they say, they touch on, they say that sex is bad and it's a scary thing. Most Christian women feel that way, and I can say that because I know some Christian women who are like that, that they don't talk about sex, or they don't whatever, like they don't do that. And they touch on basically, and they're basically saying that it's not a bad thing and you shouldn't be scared of it, that the day that you find the person you're meant to spend your life with and everything, that it will be a beautiful moment and stuff. And it's true, and that's what God has designed it for us and everything. They also say that your worth is based on your level of purityness. That's true as well. I underlined some stuff from this part, and the one thing I underlined was a Bible verse, which is Romans 5 verse 8, and it says, "But God shows His love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." That is 100% true, and I love that verse. And then I also underlined, it says, "We equal our own worth in God's eyes to our own level of purityness. We believe we need to earn our worth in Selby in God's eyes. When we do something wrong or sin, we feel that we have done wrong in God's eyes." And then that's something I struggle with. Whenever I sin or something, I just feel like I've completely failed as a person, and I feel like God doesn't love me anymore and stuff. My mom has taught me so much that if you just beg and ask for forgiveness, He will give it. And that's something that's very true. It's really good. Like I said, if you're married or in a relationship, engaged, whatever, I feel like you should read this book. It is really, really good. And it helps so much. It has helped me so much. Yeah. That's it for this video. I'm gonna leave a link in below where you can get the book. And if you want to know more about Girl Define, I'll also leave it below. I found Girl Define through a YouTube channel that was actually making fun of them. And because of that, I fell in love with Girl Define. I fell in love with Kristen and Bethany and their personalities. I found them in a time of need where I was struggling with my walk with the Lord. And their first book helped me a lot. And then last year when I was engaged and dating this guy and everything, their book Love Defined came out, and that helped me so much. I'm actually going to be rereading that book now since I'm single, and I feel like the Lord's gonna teach me so much more with that book now that I'm single and stuff. So yeah, so if you want to learn more about Girl Defined as well, I'm gonna leave their website below where you can check them out. I'll also leave their YouTube channel below, what they make YouTube videos and stuff about different topics and stuff, and they're really good and stuff. So yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, give it a thumbs up, And so remember to subscribe to my channel and like all my videos and everything. And until then, I guess I will see you in the next one.